guys, the Ape and Monkey, welcome back to the world of madness.
Madness, that is right. We are back on the server, and today we are finally finishing off the chicken farm. The thing that I've been working on for quite some time now, and I've been promising you guys I would do a video on and all that cool stuff. Well, I am finally getting around to it. Now, if you haven't seen the previous video of me working on this beast, I finished off the chicken farm, which is also a water tower, which is just because it's a Western themed spawn. And basically, all the chickens are at the top there, the eggs fall down this hopper line here, and then they land into this chest right here where you can select some, and it'll replenish from the stack above in the other chest. All these are pretty much filled now with chicken eggs. Now, obviously, we want those chicken eggs to go somewhere, mainly cooking them. So we're going to go down here. And so far, what I've done is laid out the sections that I'm going to be building on, purely because this is a complex build in my head, and I'm not very good at complex builds in my head. So what I'm going to do is speed through any sections that are long, arduous, which is basically all of it, and I'll come back and show you guys what things do, what the reason why I built things, basically. But I'll speed through them so you can see me building it, and you can get an idea of how to build it yourself if you so wish. Now, as you can see, everything's pretty much color-coded. The yellow is the actual build itself, you know, things I'm going to be covering over, making it look pretty. The green is the line for the activation. The cyan is the line for the clock timer, even. The red is the time line for all the hoppers. And, yeah, that's pretty much the only explanation you need. This is, like, clock section here and here, and then this is, like, dropper line. So what's going to happen is the eggs will go into a dropper at the bottom. The dropper will, a dispenser at the bottom. Then the dispenser will shoot out all of the eggs and make sure they hatch. When they hatch and they grow up, there'll be a lava blade right above them that keeps spotting out every so often. And when they're grown up, they will get hit by the lava blade, cook into cooked chicken and feathers. They will be collected by the hopper minecarts, which will be right here inside of our cauldron. The cauldron then will pass all of the hopper, all the items into hopper line, which will be here, all the way down to here. This will go into a hopper sorting system, so you can get all the items sorted out. So one will be feathers, and one will be cooked chicken. This will then filter into more hoppers down here, into a dropper clock, which will be right here. And I'm granting you, before you say and shout in the comments, there are also item elevators that are made of glass. Use those instead, the better. I don't care. I know they exist. Stop telling me about them. The only reason I'm using dropper elevator here is purely because it's more reliable, they get to the top quicker, and it's easier to sort them into this chest at the above when they get there. I know that you can use item elevators, I'm aware of this, but this one's silent. This dropper elevator is practically silent. You never hear it go off, which is fantastic. So, I mean, you know, what more can you ask for? So, without further ado, I'm going to speed through the sections which are going to be boring, which is pretty much most of the build, I'll be honest. But hopefully you guys will get something from it, learn how to do it yourself. And then you can build on your own server if you so wish. I know there's smaller versions, but I'd say this is the reason why it's big. It's because I want to get 100% of the items. I don't want to lose anything. A lot of the items get put into lava when you use a smaller design. So that's why I've used a big one. Anyway, let's start this off. So I'm going to go ahead and start building. I need my items, mainly the hoppers for the time being. Right, totally guys, once that section is done. Okay, so now that I've basically made a hopper line here, hopper minecart line, I'm going to start breaking them. So every time I break one of these, this one will drop into this one, so you'll have two here. Then them ones will drop into that one, so I'll have three. And those will drop into that one, which means I'll have four. That's basically how this thing works. So I've dropped this, as you can see, it disappears. But don't worry, it's in that one there. Do it again, disappears, but it's in this one. And if I just make way down here and do that, it's inside that one. And then break this one, and then break that. that'll get put in there. So now I just need to get my colour clay here, which I'm going to use as the building material. So I'm going to get my yellow, because yellow's nice and pretty. So we do that, and then let's build a little line up again, because I do need to get the top. So just build a little line like this, and then place that one right there. Okay, so basically, what I have done here, for those who are actually interested, we have a hopper line here. As I said, all the items will get filtered into that hopper minecart setup. Then they'll go into these hoppers here, and then into these hoppers here, and then at the end. Now, theoretically, because I broke all of the blocks and the minecart rails, they should have all fallen into the hoppers. Then they would have been down here, then into here, then into here. So they should be at the end here. They are. Fantastic. It works. I love when something works the first time. All right, cool. So now, once that's done, I need to put the cauldron here right next to, or inside of, I should say, the hopper minecart. Now, the reason for that is chickens will not sit in place unless they are inside a cauldron. So that's why I'm doing this. If this changes in the future of Minecraft, I'm going to be very upset because it's a very, very nice thing to have. But for the time being, we have it, which is great. So I'm going to do that, and I don't think I'll need any redstone, but I will need my building blocks to get back up to where I was, so we don't need that. We need that for a bit. No, we don't. We don't need that anymore. We can put those back. We don't need them. So basically, all I need to do is build up a little line here, then put the piston there, and then a block on top of it like that. Ooh, on there even. And then just power it from the side, and that'll put the cauldron in its place with all the hot minecarts right there, which is perfectly what we are wanting. Break that, that'll get over there, and break that as well, and that will likely, yep, that'll be over there as well now, so I can go pick it up in a second. So now that is done, hello, it works, I'm fantastic. Right, so now that's done, all I do is a timing system. Now the timing system is hopper clock, etho timer thing. I think it's ethos, I'm not 100% sure, but I believe it is ethos. So what we're gonna do is, don't wanna speed that bit up. Don't really see any point in speeding up. No, we'll do it live. We'll do it live. So we need the cobblestone to build stuff. We'll do the clock on the back of it first. So we'll do that. We need a hopper, redstone repeaters, redstone, and we need that. And we may as well bring these with us because we can go straight into doing it, actually. There we go. Get some items for the drop of fit. There we go. Cool. So we'll go behind the system, which we've got a little path here, fantastically. So now what we need to do is do a comparator clock behind it. So every time an item goes in here, this will activate this comparator clock. If I put an egg in there, as you can see, the comparator is on and the item's still in there, okay? Now what happens is, the item will get put into this, it'll power this repeater here, then it'll send a signal into the wall once I do this, there, and that'll get a shot out. Now, the way this works is I want it to basically do a clock system. Now, if there's too many items in here, you'll find that it only fires once. It's a bit of a problem. So what we do, we make a clock. So we do this, this, and then that. And that'll make it into a clock. So whenever there's an item in there, it will start shooting, which is absolutely perfect and exactly what we wanted. Now the eggs will get shot into the cauldron, which will in turn will make them hatch, and then the eggs will be chickens, and then we'll have lovely baby chickens, which will then grow up into what I need them to be, which is what I want them to be. So now I need to do the timer bit. So what we're gonna do is build up here, lovely noise there, scary noises. Okay, so what we're gonna do is put do we need a piston there? Oh no, sorry, the piston's above it. So it's pistons there, that's it. So we break that one there, we don't need it. Give me it back. And then we put a bit of redstone there. Then a piston there. And then we want a bit of redstone on the back of that one as well. So we got any redstone now? We haven't, so we'll just make some. Like so. Thank you. And then we're gonna put a redstone block between it. Which is right there, that's fine. And then we want the hoppers like this. So one facing that way. Yep, one facing that way. And then the other one facing the other way, which I'll need to build out on here. Then break that one. And then put that there. Right, so now we've got a hot facing that way, a hot facing that way. So this is an ether timer. I'm sure you've seen them 1,000 times on the internet. So we put some items in here, so like this. So we'll put, say, 10 items should be enough. So we'll just, there we go, 10 items. Then that'll slide over. Once all the items are transferred from this hop to that one, it'll slide back. Once all the items are transferred from this one to that one, it will slide back. And this is how it works, okay? Really, really, really simple. And that'll be our timer. So by the time the chicken has grown up, It will then lava blade, and once it is lava bladed, it will then send a signal through, which is perfect. So I'm going to go ahead and finish off some of these sections, and then I'll be back once they are done. Okay, so what we've got going on now is the hopper clock will power this, which then will power this monostable circuit. As you can see, it sends through one tick pulse, and then that will send a signal to the dispenser here, which will turn on and off really quickly. If I actually build a little tower up, you'll see it go on. So this will turn the clock on and off really quickly, so watch. You hear it click twice. So there it goes on, which means the lava bucket will come out, and then the lava bucket will get retracted. So we'll get basically a system where it turns the sends out lava, then pulls it back really quickly, which is what we need. We just need to burn the chickens slightly before they die, because they'll start burning to death, which is perfect. So now that this section's done, and we're actually going to remove the items from here for the time being, because it will get really quick and be annoying as hell. So now that the items we'll remove this from there, we'll start on the actual hopper dispenser, even the dispenser elevator, drop evader. That's the one. We'll work on the drop evader. So the items will then get put into a redstone line, which will be on here. So what we need to do is put a comparator. We need more comparators. Okay, this is good. Right, I'm gonna go ahead and get some more comparators, and I'll be right back once I've done that. I forgot how many I needed. Right, BRB, guys, BRB. Okay, so I got myself another comparator, fantastically. Right, so now what I need to do is put the comparator going from this there and that there, okay? Then we want to put the redstone lines. So we're going to go one there, then redstone going from there, to there. Need some more redstone, give me some 9 pieces. Right, then we need to do is get a repeater going from that bit to there, and then that one to there with a redstone going there and a redstone going there. So basically what this will do, will send a signal once the droppers are full. So I'm gonna get some droppers here and I'll show you what I mean. So once the dropper is lined up here, we'll just do one there and one there. So as you can see, because there's items in this dropper now, there's a dropper in the dropper. There's a dropper in the, sorry, there's a hopper in the dropper. I hate that they're so similar names. So now there's a hopper in the, now there's an item in the dropper. It'll send a signal into this, which will then send a signal into this hopper here, telling it not to send any more items through. And then once there's not items in this, it'll send another item through. So basically what it means is it'll only send an item at a time. So if I put in 8 redstone, you'll see it'll get all 8 redstone into here. Now if I pull an item out of here, one item comes through, but no more. But do again, one item comes through, but no more. And it'll just keep doing this. And then once they travel up, it'll mean that they're completely finished. It'll pretty much mean that once all these are out, this one will let anything through and there won't be no more signal anymore. So, now we've done that bit, I'm going to go ahead and build a giant elevator of droppers? Droppers. I'm going to go build a giant elevator of droppers, and I'll be right back once that is done. Yay, drop evader. So we've got the dropper there now, as you can see, a very nice line of droppers going from bottom to top, and that'll send all the items to the surface. Now what we need is the signal, basically the pulse that'll send a line up the side of this thing to say, transfer the item from there to there to there to there to there to there, over and over again. So for that, we're just going to build a nice little system like this. We'll go one up and then one over. So we're going to do redstone, 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 and then a torch in the back of here like that, then torches there. Like that, and this will just build up over time. So we'll go one there, then redstone torch there, there, then redstone torches on the front, there and there, and then this will just go up like this the entire way up. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's a long and arduous process, so I'll go ahead and do that and be back once that is done. Oh god, it's going to take forever. Yay! Thank you. Absolutely beautiful. So now we've got a giant elevator of droppers, which will send the items all the way at the top. So if we test this out now, it should work beautifully. So we'll put any item in. So it's for 5, because that way it's a nice little small number. So we put 5 in there. So that'll send the items all the way at the top, as you can see. Only time it's ticking is at the very top, and that's going to have a hopper on it, so you won't even hear it when it gets to the top anyway. So we go to the top now, we should see 5 items all waiting for us. There's a stack there, so we'll just get rid of... We've got 13 on us, so 13 plus 5 equals 17. That's wrong. There's one in there. Okay, so we'll lose 1 from the looks of it, and it'll be in this dropper here, which I don't think is that much of a problem. We lose 1 item. I don't see that much of being a problem, really, considering we're going to get a load of chickens in this thing, hopefully, theoretically. So that is totally fine with me. I'm not fussed about losing 1 item, 1 feather and 1 cooked chicken. I hope you guys are okay with that as well. If you're not, complain at me in the comments. I don't mind. So now that that's done, we need to... figure out the item sorting system. So I'm going to go and get some more comparators, because I do need them. I keep forgetting to get comparators. So I'm going to get some more comparators, and then I'll be right back once that is done. Ah, oh, comparators. Why do I need so many of you guys? Okay, this time I have 6. I don't think I'll need 6, but I made 6 nevertheless, because I figured, why not? Just on the off chance. Just on the very off chance that I'm going to need 6, I've made 6. So, you know, I can't be, like, wrong, basically. So now we need to make the item sorting system. So for that, what we need is to do a line of redstone there, a line of redstone there. It's a really simple system, this. It's been used around the internet many a time. So now we need to put the... actually, I'll get rid of these and take away that one I just placed down. So we put the repeaters there. Then the clay back where it was, like that. And get out my hole. I can't get out my hole. I'm stuck in a hole and I can't get out. Okay, there we go. Right, and then put the redstone on that bit there. And then we're going to put the comparators right... right there, if I can get it. Right, that's a repeater. That's a repeater anyway. I need to put the comparator. I can't place it. Ah, damn. Can I break this? I think I can. Yeah, I can. All right, cool. So I'm going to put one there. Yeah, there we go. And then one here, like that. Don't need to be in division mode. Then we'll just fill it back where it was. So this is basically the item sorter. Oh, we need to put redstone torches. Just 2 draw touches, I've got 2 left. Fantastic. So one right there and one right there. That's perfect. Absolutely perfect. Right, so basically this is the sorting system. It's a really simple design. Basically what happens is when there are more than 18 items, a stack of 18, so 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. When there are 23 items in this system, that will send a little signal to this comparator here, which will then unlock this hopper here, which will then let 1 item through. It's really, really simple. So what I'll show you is if I go line of them, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, so 18 basically, 18 total there. So now there's 18 in there. You'll see that this comparator's on, and there's no signal going into there, and it's only powering up to this redstone line here. If I put one more item in, keep an eye on this repeater. If I put one more item in, like this, it doesn't stay in for now. Not the repeater, sorry. Keep an eye on the torch underneath, if I can get it in shot. There we go. So keep an eye on the torch underneath. Put one item in, it turns off very slightly. So there you go. And that lets one item through. So all these items are getting put into here, which will then get put into this hopper line, or dropper line here, which then goes right at the top. And we can go and collect our items from the top here. And you'll see that they're all just waiting for us in a nice little pile, minus the one that's left in the dropper there. Fantastic. So it works. We have something that works. Yay! So now all I need to do is cover this thing up. I think everything's done. We need to finish the line here. Now when I do this, you'll hear a lot of hoppers going off. The dropper going off like crazy. So I'm going to put one hopper right here, and this should start the entire system. And we also need to put a bucket of lava, which I'll get in a second. So that is pretty much it, so I'm just going to do that. There we go, starting to shoot out the eggs. Fantastic. And we also need to put a system at the top here to collect them all. So we'll just do a dropper like that, and a dropper like that for now. We're going to make a chicken coop out of this, but that'll be in the next episode, because it's going to be a long build, that one as well. So we'll make it like a chicken coop to hide all these things in and make it look a bit more aesthetically pleasing. But for the time being, I just need to get a bucket of lava, which I don't have any lava on me, or any buckets. So I'm going to go ahead and get that, and then I'll be right back with that is done. Where can I find lava? On the hunt for lava. To the never! I know where to get lava. Never. Okay, I got lava and I got enough chicken and feathers for the system to do the sorting part of it. So I'm gonna go back down the bottom here. Ah, so many minecart noises. Yeah, it's really loud down here. Never usually this loud. Don't know what's going on. Right, so all you do. Ah, it's really loud. Where? Player sounds? Volume sounds? I'm not sure what controls the thing, so I'm just gonna do that. So, now the system is in place, we're just gonna put the lava in the top here, like that. And then put the sorting system here in place as well. So in this one, I'm going to get rid of all this cobblestone. We don't need it. In this one, we want to put the chicken. No, we'll put the feathers in this one. So a line, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. All right, cool. 18 in there. And then in this one, we want to put a line followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 16, 17, 18. There we go. Fantastic. So 18 and 18 plus the others. That's done. We are done. This is it. So if I put a chicken in there, if I put a chicken in here, say, you'll see it go. If I put a chicken in here, it goes down this line and then up one of these lines. It did get sorted. I'm fairly certain of that. Yeah. And then we'll put a feather in there like that and that'll get sorted. So if I go to the top here, you should see there's a chicken and a feather waiting for us. Hopefully. I hope. One in here? Nope. One in here? Nope. In here? Nope. Where the hell is it? Okay, there's a cobblestone. Something's broken. What could it be? I actually don't know what's broken here. That should have worked. 18. There's a feather in there. For some reason, that did not get filtered out correctly. Huh. This is a bug, guys. I'm not sure what the bug is, though. Oh, I hate when this happens. Right. When something goes wrong, you don't know what it is. Okay. That's sending out a signal. Maybe these need to be on two ticks. I think, maybe. I'm not sure if they do, though. Right, we'll put a chicken in there. And we will remove this so I don't have to go at the top. Right, so we'll just remove that. So I'll put chicken here. Like that. And then that gets filtered into... Oh, wait, I'm putting the wrong one, aren't I? Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Let's see what goes in. Is it in there? There's one in there. I'm not sure what's going on here. This has never happened before. Why is it doing it now? All right. I don't know what's going on. So maybe one item gets stuck in there and then... Maybe it's lag? I don't actually know. This shouldn't be happening. This wasn't happening before. Why is it doing it now? I'm confused, guys. If you can tell me in the comments why this might be happening, I'm thinking lag. That's my main guess. Get rid of that one. Okay, get rid of that and get rid of that. I don't know what that's sending it, because there's nothing in it. So, yeah, nothing in there, nothing in there, nothing in there. Right. So we got 18 and 18. That's right. We put a chicken in there. That'll get sent to here, to here, to there, or into the hopper below. Okay, so it's going to lose two items. This entire system loses two items. I'm okay with that, to be honest. It's less than, you know, any other system I've seen. So we lose two items, but they get through the system later on anyway. So I'm not going to be too fussed with that. I think I'm okay with it. I'm just going to leave it as is. Happy enough with it as it is like that. That needs facing another way. Help? How do I do this now? Pillar up? And then... Dropper? There we go. And then... can't reach it from there. Pillar up? And then dropper? Like that. Alright, cool. So that is it, guys. We are done with the chicken cooker. This is all now cooking chicken. We just need to kind of fill over these hoppers with furnaces to stop lag, as much lag as possible. So we're gonna put a furnace on top of all these hoppers. If you don't know the reason behind that is, I'll link you in the description to Sparks' video, where he goes over what the issues are with hoppers and items on top of them, and basically solid blocks. So if you put a furnace on top, it stops that from happening. So we're gonna put a furnace on top of all this stuff, when I'm way off camera. And we're done. We are done, guys. So if you want to make this yourself, as I say, I've sped through it, so you hopefully you can follow along. If you don't follow along, I may do a schematic, which you can download at some point and work on it yourself. I still need to put the items back in here, so we'll do 10 items in there. So 10 items, there we go. So that's on the work now. The lava will flow out the top of this thing and then burn the chickens to death. So we'll just, if you look over the top here, you'll see lava, no lava. Gets taken away really quickly. That's how that works. Really simple. Anyway, guys, until next time, TTYL, peace out, and bye-bye. Chicken. Chicken for everyone. Chicken. I love chicken. It is so tasty. I will eat forever chicken. Ah, I need more. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. Ooh, chicken. Nom, 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 nom. Bye, guys.